Monica Puig to begin this gold medal match. The Puerto Rican is serving against Angelique Kerber from Germany.
Ready. Señoras y señores, las jugadoras están preparadas. Brigada.
Backhand going wide from Puig, who is ranked number 34 in the world. Kerber number 2. Change of direction. We were talking about the forehand down the line.
Just the start here that Kerber wants. Use her experience, try and get the jump on Puig. And if Puig can help it though. She has had an amazing run, an inspired run through the Olympic tournament. With the number 14 seed, Pavlyuchenkova. Garbiñe Muguruza. That she's thinking very clearly out here, not suffering nerves. Had some practice against a left-hander in the semi-final as well, defeating Petra Kvitova.
Point began with a great kick serve from Puig. Impressive. From love 30, in this situation against a player who's been on the bigger stages, rallying for the next 3 points. Somebody who likes to be aggressive from the back of the court, Puig. Nice steady, steady backhand. Likes to go for it on the forehand.
Another of Kerber's most effective shots. Getting great curve on the forehand. Making it travel away from Puig. Drags her opponents out of court so well.
And a break chance.
Thank you.
Just look at that from Kerber. Phenomenal.
That really was. It was a well-played point by Puig.
First game.
Kerber defending, moving so well around the court, as she always does.
Señoras y señores, siéntase rápidamente, por favor. Obrigada.
You chart her unforced errors in this tournament, Kerber. They've gone from 31 to 19 to 14 to 11 to 8. So in a downhill direction, very stingy against Keys, just to make those 8 unforced errors. Keys having those 10 break points, didn't convert any of them, but she said after the match that on the overwhelming majority of them, Kerber played such good points.
Puig knows she really has to be aggressive in this match. Can't afford to just get into rallies and not try and do anything in the points. So that stands her in good stead. That's her style. Gets quite a bit of sting on her ground strokes off both sides. The forehand that she hits the most winners off, but still quite a few coming from the backhand of Puig also. No weaknesses evident.
So beautifully, she came on top of the backhand, but still powered through the backhand to create 2 break points herself.
14.
Great return from Puig, going right down the middle, hard and true, as she was doing in the semifinals against Petra Kvitova.
Throughout all of her matches here in Rio, she has been hitting that return so well, back almost at the feet of the server, very much down the middle, not giving her opponent any angles to play with, and catching them just with the pace of it.
Yeah, pretty good run in Brazil prior to this event, making the semifinals in Florianopolis. So got a chance to get used to the conditions in Brazil. And there have been varying conditions the entire week.
And that has to be an advantage of being in this time zone, also a little bit longer. Quite a few of the players had to come from drastically different time zones, a long way away. Very much straight before the tournament, and I don't think it was great preparation for them. Out!
Getting some luck to get to 30-15.
30-15.
Puerto Rico is such a small nation, 3.5 million people, only had 2 medalists at London 2012. She is expecting all of Puerto Rico, she said, Puig, to be watching this match. this early start by both players is any indication, then we're in for a treat. Torben Belts there, bottom right. Barbara Rittner, Fed Cup captain. Laura Siegman, who was one of the players that Puig beat en route to the final, crushed actually. She's also taking this one in.
That is brilliant play from Puig. Not afraid to come forward when she gets the chance. Well finished off. It was the shot down the line that set it up.
Got the balance right in terms of patience. When to hit the big shot. Into this match as the firm underdog Monica Puig got broken. But look at that recovery. Has won the next two games. They're on serve 2-1. Evening time in Rio. Now the eyes of the not only world but tennis world obviously on this gold medal match between Kerber and Puig. Just like the court positioning there from Kerber inside the baseline.
Brilliant from Kerber, just so solid. Rave reviews for her defensive game. But it's the way she can turn it to attack. Just gets a lot on her shots.
Firm hold there. from Kerber to get to two games all. Players have met two times in the past, both times going to Kerber. First one was in Brisbane. Tight one, 3-6, 6-4, 7-6. Kerber was 2 points away from defeat in that one. And then in Toronto, 2015, 6-2, 6-3 to Kerber. Not a great serving day that day for Puig. No aces, five double faults. Also won less than 55% of her first and second serve points and faced 12 break points.
Kerber will be aware that Puig has really improved since then. It's really been this year that she's made the biggest inroads in her career. Started at number 94 in the world, played as a qualifier in Sydney in January and reached the final there. Tremendous performance.
He's checking with the champion. No challenge from Kerber. Yes, quite the turnaround. Last year she lost first round 12 times, which is remarkable. Then made a coaching change last year, Juan Todaro, placing Ricardo Sanchez.
That is a great shot, pinpoint accuracy. Kerber forced into the crouch to defend, and with that ball sitting up, Puig right over the top of it.
Somebody I guess you would describe as a very clean ball striker.
Very much so. Very consistent off both sides, but also really capable of some big shots. Some very quick shots. Has good accuracy around the court.
How many serves does she have to hit?
And quite deceptive with the way she lines up for that forehand. She can put it either way. A good serve there, getting the short return. You won't see her miss many of those.
I like the way she moves in, hits the ball, continues to move her body in. Weight into the shot. They trade comfortable holds. And through five games, it's Puig who leads 3-2. Angelique Kerber would have expected, I think, a battle going into this match in the first few games, living up to it. She trails 3-2, but we're on serve. And then she would have taken note of the fine year that Tui has had.
When a player improves some 60 ranking spots over the course of a year, qualifies for tournaments and gets through, you take notice. There's that return again, right back at Kerber. What an angle. Looking to be in a bit of trouble in this service game. Kerber just gets the wrist over that backhand. Brilliant defense from the German. Puig had her on the ropes.
Interesting, the contrast, Karen, when she strikes the ball, Kerber, a little bit more flat to the ground. She doesn't move into the ball as much, but she generates so much power because of the great lower body that she has, the power she has. But not enough there to get that backhand over the net. A break point for Puig.
That's it, 14.
Barely has time to recover from the serve when that is bulleting straight back at her.
At the first serve in. And it is a lefty serve, so a different look for Puig. Yes, she did face a left-hander also in the semifinals in Kvitova. Different trajectory, Kvitova. Yeah, she held it together in that one. We were talking about the composure. She was down 3-love in that match against Kvitova. Yes, got a few errors also from Kvitova, but stuck to her game, and she had a game plan in that one. Patient, don't get rattled if her opponent starts off really well, which she did.
Trying to be very aggressive on that return. It just came on to her a bit more quickly than she expected. Just a bit more about the year of Monica Puig. Kerber reaching this, winning the Australian Open this year, defeating Serena Williams, and then reaching the Wimbledon final. Puig coming out of qualifying in the lower tier events to really establish herself on the WTA Tour. So a big difference where they're at in their careers, but Puig, a huge improver. Qualified and reached a semi-final at Eastbourne, wins over Wozniacki and Ladenovic, a semi-final at Nottingham.
It's a great combination. The serve out wide, powerful serve opening up the court. A mistake on the last wall.
Pleasing the Puerto Rican fans.
She is, as she put it, not doing her job in this situation, but representing her country. And doing it well.
She certainly is, and that's really quite an interesting distinction, that description. A lot of players talk about the pride they have in representing their country, but she's saying this is different to her week in, week out profession. This is something different. And she has said that she rates the Olympics ahead of the Grand Slams in terms of importance for her career, for her, and certainly for her country.
Hitting winners against Kerber is not an easy thing to do, but she is hitting winners against the German. Times make it look easy. We move along on serve in the first set. Angelique Kerber may have the distinct edge in the ranking, but it's not telling so far in the gold medal match.
Well, that strategy has been paying off in spades for Puig all week. Too much Kerber can do about that. Hard to react.
Kerber's own season began with pretty good effect in Brisbane, made the final, loss to Victoria Azarenka, but then beat her at the Australian Open, which is a big upset. Taking out Serena in the final, 6-4 in the third. Australian Open actually began for her, but she had to save a match point against Misaki Doi. So what about that? Saves the match point in the first round, goes on to win the title. I was waiting for the call. Finally came. And since that time, she's had to cope with the pressure of being a Grand Slam winner. That combined with the shoulder injury surfaced during the clay court campaign, sought in a loss to Eugenie Bouchard, affected her at the French Open. That also with a tough opponent, Kiki Bertens. Then made the recovery on the grass at Wimbledon. High quality final against Serena. So didn't do much wrong in that final. Serena just better on the day. Sensing there, after what she's witnessed in the first seven games, that she needs to do a bit more to move Puig around, not let her set from the baseline.
Brilliant point from Puig. Totally dominating that rally.
15 love.
She's the player who is on or inside the baseline.
That's 14 winners already. And again, take into consideration who she's playing.
And the fact she's never been in as big a match as this. That's the other factor that's quite incredible. Kerber finally finishing that point off.
15-0.
Mentioned the name of Graf earlier, Karen, somebody that Kerber really looked up to. Had a chance to even hit with her last year. She talked about that as being a turning point in her career. Just Steffi giving her the confidence, the belief that she could do it. Really up her game.
So good from Cook. Talking about confidence and belief, you can see that Puig has that, the way she has progressed through the tournament to make this final unseeded, unexpected, which she's arrived as if she belongs.
Maybe that's the first time she's made the wrong decision in this match. Do you get a feel for Puig and the way she talks? You know, you hear what she says. She really does believe that she should be at the top of the game. So she's going out here thinking, yeah, I do have a chance in this one. A double or triple net court.
It took a while to make up its mind.
14-13.
Relief for Puig with that trickling over.
That net court, we can say, for the time being, made in Puerto Rico. To do with the net cord there. Crisp backhand winner. She's a game away from taking the opening set, 5-4. Angelique Kerber serving to stay in this first set.
Distracted herself with that challenge, which seems a bit strange. It was clearly right.
Yeah.
Just fabulous hitting. Look at Kerber. Just motion there to your leg.
Well, certainly grimace. Didn't serve full pace in that point. 125 kilometers an hour, the serve. Brilliant point from Puig.
Oh, narrowly wide. Looks like she's slowing down at the back of the court, yes. Does have a physical style of play, demanding style of play, Kerber. It's long.
She's hurting.
Yep, shake of the head there. Something is up with Kerber.
Well, she's not going to be letting her opponent know about this unless it's quite bad.
Two set points. Help with the net cord, but it looked like he was going to be a winner in any case. Monica Puig has taken the first set, 6-4 over Angelique Kerber, a Kerber who may be feeling it physically.
Stunning first set for Monica Puig. You might have expected a few nerves. Player ranked number 34, unseeded. Kerber getting some treatment. Certainly limping in that last game. Seemed to be the left leg that she was having trouble with. Let's hope she's all right. Very disappointing if she is severely hampered.
Medical timeout complete.
Puig to serve.
And Monica Puig to begin the second set.
She's willing to put full weight on that leg.
Well, she looked okay there. And there also.
Brilliant point from Kerber, and certainly looking like full movement. Really tested out in that point, producing the goods. You see this happen so often where a player has a lead, there's an injury or medical timeout, and they lose their concentration and momentum.
Thank you.
pinpoint accuracy again. Brilliant hitting from the Puerto Rican.
15-14.
Great depth up the middle, and then she spreads the ball wide there with the off backhand.
Forehand goes long, Kerber breaks.
First game, second set.
Of course, she was well within her rights to take the medical timeout, but the unfortunate consequence for Puig is that she had to sit there and just wait and wait and wait. Cooled off.
It's difficult. All right, Kerber needed the treatment. She's obviously benefited from it. To see. You're moving freely.
End of the first set also had some issues with the serve hitting a double fault. Oh, what a volley!
Puig challenging this one, hoping that it might have dropped wide, but it's plumb on the line.
Plumb as it can be, look at that.
15.
Some great depth from Puig in that point, but Kerber absorbing it. How she manages to turn those points around.
Two challenges remaining.
Credit to her.
Just struggling with the serve, hitting some double faults. There is an ace from Kerber. Back-to-back aces.
Cavaliers,
has three total.
What a performance from Kerber, really lifting on her serve. Test here for Puig to see if she can steady things, hold on to a serve. She's definitely gone off the boil. A rare miss on that forehand side, which is usually hit with such certainty.
great tennis.
That is an absolutely brilliant point from Puig. She was in all sorts of trouble, had to cover a lot of ground, and was clever enough to slow things down, give herself time to get back in the point. Great depth on that approach. Makes the volley.
Someone who loves a target, Kerber, and you thought she was going to win the point when she had the forehand. How many times did we see it in the final in Melbourne against Serena? Just some great counterpunching from Kerber also throughout the year. But again, worth saying, she's moving beautifully now, Kerber.
Dragging that one into the net for the second time in this game.
13, 14.
Will she open up a two-break advantage? She went for it for the clean winner. Can't begrudge her for doing that. She wants to introduce that into her game and do that more and more, just missing on the execution.
Wonderful hitting down the lines from Puig. Job Kerber capitalizing on that second serve,
yes.
Not having enough on it. She pounced.
By moving in just that little bit, taking it early, did not give Kerber, somebody who moves so well, time to react.
Advantage, Puig.
Be a pivotal game. She was down a break point, saves it, keeps it close in the second set.
Thank you.
Kerber serving in second set, up a break. She set up the point so well.
An awful miss there for Puig. Late and dragged it down. And what a difference it would have made if she would have taken that first point.
Picking it up on serve, Kerber, three aces in the second set.
It's amazing just the difference when you see your opponent make an error, as Monica did in that opening point. Just gives Kerber that bit more confidence. She thinks,
How about that? Yet another ace from Kerber.
She's really up the ante with her serve.
I wonder, is that because she feels better physically? Is it because she feels like she needs to do more and is going for? Or maybe it's a combination of those things.
Certainly, I think an effort for quicker points off the serve.
She made 10 unforced errors in the first set, Puig. So far, 6 in the second set. And Kerber lifting her game.
15-13.
Kerber frustrated at the back of the court. Another one falls in the favor of Puig.
That's you.
Comes back with the ace. I mean, she is a flat hitter of the ball to generate the good pace and maybe just get the momentum to take it over the net on those net cords. She also got one in the semifinals at a critical stage in the first set, third set, I should say, first game when she was behind. You win some, you lose some. Thanks for that. All the timing.
Critical game, particularly for Puig. Great shot.
That shot was applauded by Kerber. Splendid. Splendid from Puig. After a slightly wavering to begin the second set, looks like she's finding some of that form of the first set. Kerber leads, though, 3-2. Puerto Rican bench, looking out also agent there, just at the far left of the screen. They'll be proud of what they're seeing, proud of what she's done so far at the Olympics. She's challenging Puig, who is making her first appearance at the Olympics. Oh, it was a good challenge, judging by that, but it was long. Something that Puig has been doing, moving in, taking it early.
And she was able to, on that occasion, with Puig just dropping that ball a little shorter. So it takes both of these women will go on the attack. Play again, the strategy of the return straight back at Kerber, spreads it wide and goes on the attack.
And she has shown she can play at the net. Puig, first volley, it was very good.
Kerber serve has really improved in the second set, smacking aces. 5th for the set.
Second serve of Kerber, still attackable, and Puig does take advantage.
Well, if there is any weakness in the Kerber game, it is the second serve. Puig willing to go after it. Point from Puig. Checking into the forehand side of Kerber. Just dragging it further and further out.
Yes.
And finishing off down the line. Precision play.
The net cord helping Kerber, setting up the forehand.
Advantage, Kerber.
Kerber making her second appearance at the Olympics. Played in London. Singles, doubles, and mixed, in fact.
Game, Kerber.
She's putting on a serving clinic in the second set, Kerber. As we're into the quarterfinals in London. I think they will go on to win the bronze medal. The second round in the doubles with Nozicki to the Williams sisters, who would win gold. And then in the mixed to Munin Azarenka, who would go on to win gold. So tough draws for her in 2012. Different player now, Grand Slam winner. Short of a medal in Rio. Which color is it going to be? New balls for Puig. Oh, just so impressive. How many times have we seen it this year? Also over the years in a defensive position, but then hits the winning shot from it.
You're seemingly coming up with the impossible. Puig did nothing wrong in that point. Kerber. Something brilliant.
She does hit that running forehand, the cross-court running forehand, amazingly. Doesn't hide her emotions, Kerber. You know what she's thinking on the court.
Great hitting from Puig. A must-win service game for her here. She wants to stay in this second set.
Two in this game. Second serve returns.
40, 15.
Yeah, nothing she could do. Began with a good serve from Puig and covers the backhand.
We're into
the business end of this second set now, 4-3.
Gracias.
Angelique Kerber trying to become the second German women's singles champion after Steffi Graf in 1988. She broke to begin the contest, and then quickly lifted her game. Kerber taking medical timeout, and after the medical timeout, moving better, serving bigger. Kerber did not hit the ace, went out wide with the lefty serve.
Job complete, keeping that ball very low.
15, 13.
There is Belts, worked with her for a long time. Her first stint, then they had cut ties, back together a couple of years ago.
How about the length from Puig?
Two break chances for Puig to level in the second set. Such a long rally, and the longer you went, you thought it would favor Kerber. But it's Puig who won the point, and she does break for 4-0.
Puerto Rican fans in full voice. What a tremendous point from that player. Three times she hit within a centimeter of the baseline. Incredible depth.
Oh, what an opportunity for Puig.
How about the speed around the court? Running those shots down.
Love 50.
Almost doing a Kerber on Kerber. Courageous hitting. She's going after her shots. Aggressive style of play that has seen her reach this gold medal final.
Great footwork there on the back end from Puig, who is the only player from her country ranked on the tour. Just look what she's hitting.
On the baseline, really giving Kerber no room, 15. Smothering her.
That missed, but not by much.
This is such high quality tennis. You set up and with Kerber in the second, it means that you're playing some amazing winners.
She's yet to hit any errors that would lead you to believe she's getting nervous in the situation.
Just a couple of forehands early in this set. Nothing since then.
Point to get to 5-4. If she does get to 5-4, Kerber would be under loads of pressure. But it's Kerber applying the pressure with the forehand. Flirting with danger, hitting that shot against Kerber has to be so precise.
Advantage, Kerber.
And Kerber being so quick, that drop shot just was not fine enough.
From game point now to break point. That backhand from Puig, the entire rally.
Exceptional tennis from Puig. Really brave shot making.
Double fault from Puig. I talked about maybe that she was hitting through a shot. Didn't seem like she was getting nervous or tight. That double fault, perhaps a suggestion that she is feeling it. She set up the point so well this time, Kerber. Great point construction, finishing with the backhand winner. And instead of serving to stay in the match, she's serving to take us to a third set.
time.
Angelique Kerber serving at 5-4 in the second set.
15-0.
Gripping contest between these two. So turning more into the match like Brisbane 2013 rather than the lopsided one in Toronto. It's wide, and very quickly, Angelique Kerber is out to 40-love. Three set points. Had the room, space there to go for that shot, Kerber.
40-15.
Turn from Puig, deep into the corner.
30 angle she created, Puig. She's not giving in.
She most certainly is not coming up with a spectacular forehand.
Yes.
Wonderful angle, not as much pace.
Wait a little bit for that second serve. Her timing was off.
It was only 120.
Four set point.
She keeps on going for it, showing so much courage.
Yes.
Given any little chance, we'll step up, change the direction of the shot.
together.
Fifth chance for Kerber. She takes it. A roar from Kerber. The second seed has leveled in this gold medal match. The third and final set.
Well, Kerber was very fortunate to get out of a very tight situation in that second set. I think she'll be very determined in this third. Puig, she's played a great match, wants to keep it up. I think we'll see her continue with attacking tennis. Just like that. Get forward in the court whenever she can. She's really been playing fearlessly.
I think that's one of the questions. Can she maintain the level? She's played a good first set, good second set. Can she do it again in this third and final set?
In a regular tour event, I'd probably say no. But it's the Olympic Games. She has all of Puerto Rico wanting her to win this medal. And it's very special to her. Says her country needs this. Had some hard times lately with recession. She wants to bring it home for them. It's not going to be easy. What a great start to this third set.
I wonder if any part of Kerber's thinking, where is this coming from? Surely this has to slow down at some point.
Depends if you believe in fairy tales.
Well, it could be the career turning, the career defining moment for a player who's ranked outside the top 30. After this event, she could just continue to move up and up in the ranking points from the Olympics. But the momentum, you figure she could just keep on moving up even higher in the rankings and then settle at a certain point in the rankings at a very high level.
That's true, but you know, in terms of rankings, that's not the issue here. It's all about that national pride that I think she's riding high on. Because Puig had a mini breakthrough, if you like, back in 2013 in her very first Grand Slam, reached the third round at Roland Garros, having a couple of very big wins, but couldn't sustain the results that she got so quickly, was inside the top 50. And you can see why with the game she's got. And her explanation of not being able to sustain those things was, well, like wine, it matures and it gets better.
You could see that. She's still very young. In tennis terms, still very young.
22. It is young, and she was only 19 then. 18, 19. Extraordinary defense from Kerber.
The backhand from Puig is a thing of beauty.
Kerber so quickly onto that ball. Doesn't give Puig any time there, any chance.
Changing the direction there, coming down the line. I think many will recall last year what Puig did at the U.S. Open. She was down three match points to Venus Williams in a second set tiebreak. Saved those, took the three, ended up exiting three, but it was a great fight from Puig. There's a little wry smile from the coach of Kerber, previous point, which may have suggested, wow, this is amazing. She's got to be cooling down sometime. Almost identical winner. So here in Kerber's first service game of the third, break point. Nets the backhand. Puig is the first to break in the final set. After what was an interesting return.
A strange return. The serve slow at 115. Surprised that she didn't really attack it. Maybe trying the element of surprise or maybe feeling a little tight. I think so. It was a wonderful game from her.
She was in this position in the semifinals, third set, relatively early break. Pegged back, got the break again. And did have the advantage of serving first, as she's doing in this match.
Time a very good choice of shot and well executed, even getting applause from Kerber. Puig is just pushing Kerber around. Hitting some spectacular shots. Kerber having to throw herself at them to defend.
Relentless. Over from the chair.
Kerber walked. What a get. Let's hope Puig is all right. That was a nasty spill. Down a game point. Extraordinary get there from Angie Kerber. Yes.
Just the right ankle.
Should take her time. Probably a little shaken up by that. Recovery right over the top of that backhand. Kerber feeling under attack here, thinking she could weather a storm that was going to pass, but showing no signs of passing.
Forehand from Puig. Kerber scurry there, forcing the error. She builds on the break and leads 3-love. Angelique Kerber in a hole in this third set, love three. She was looking to her camp last game and obviously didn't like what they said because she had this annoyed shake of the head. Tough being in the box. Not meant to be coaching in the box, meant is the key word.
She could well have just been shaking her head in disbelief at the quality of tennis that is coming from Monica Puig.
We got more congratulations from Chris Abbott after making the final. Getting a lot of support, obviously, from back home. Hasn't really done that in this set. In the second set, flurry of aces that helped their cause, not so much in the third. And the way that Puig is hitting off the ground, you'd think she needs to do more of that.
Puig just keeps coming up with these shots, that one with great shape. Suddenly, it's not quite as comfortable a service game.
less comfortable now. Just thinking too that this year, a shot that's really worked well for Kerber in spots. We saw it in the Australian Open final. Also throughout Wimbledon is the drop shot. And I don't think she's played one the entire match. Yes, you have to pick your spots and you can't just do it randomly, but Quick is getting a chance to just stay at the back of the court in that comfort zone.
Try the drop shot there, and I think the reason Kerber hasn't been able to play the drop shot, she's just been pushed back all the time, can't get forward in the court to play the drop shot, whereas Quick, she's had a lot of chances there and been able to mix it up a little bit more. Didn't work for her that time.
That was a let off there for Kerber. Big chance for Puig to set up what would have been a break point. Game point. She's challenging.
This will be the first double fault in this set, and it is.
Three double faults overall for Kerber. Well, that first one was not easy because she has to generate all the pace herself.
Playing an inspired match out here, Puig.
Advantage, Puig.
Is this realistically a match point, or is it too early to say that? Well, it's a big point nonetheless. Well, that drop shot was ill-advised. In fact, she panicked there, thinking, okay, I'm getting so bullied off the ground, I'm going to try it right away. Bottom of the net, for love.
You're spot on with the word bullied, because she's been pushed around, Angie Kerber. She's played all the big hitters in the game, taken them on. Beat them a lot of the time. Monica Puig is playing good aggressive tennis.
Obrigada.
In the zone, keeping the errors down.
Love 50.
Didn't stop. Well, full love in the third set. She knows that she has a massive opportunity here. She's worked so hard to get to this position. She can't think about it now and tighten up.
Kerber can ill afford to do that at this stage when time is running out.
And also when her opponent's just thrown a double fault in is showing that she's perhaps a little nervous, getting very close to the finish line. Such an important result it would be for her.
Yes.
No tightening up there. Keeping her cool. 45 winners Puig has cranked out. 27 unforced errors, a brilliant ratio.
On this court, in this big final against Angelique Kerber. Overcame the double fault to begin the game.
30.
Could use a bit more of that, seeing some second serves in that position. She nets it! A brilliant stretch from Puig after what was a fabulous second serve. A great return from Kerber. It looked like Kerber was going to have the upper hand with the backhand passing shot, but sends it into the net. One more game required for Monica Puig. 5-love. Angelique Kerber is serving to stay in this final. Down 5-love. We've seen strange things happen in tennis. Can't see this happening, a comeback from Kerber.
Well, it would have to be a meltdown from Puig, you would think, because Kerber's feeling rattled. The scoreline, just the way her opponent has been playing.
Still chasing there, Puig. The names that have won Olympic gold in the women's event since tennis was introduced: Graf, Capriati, Davenport, Venus, Hene, Dementieva, Serena. Looks like Craig will be joining them. Only one on that list was not a Grand Slam winner. Dementieva, who's been a Grand Slam finalist. It really bodes well if we can win this going forward. Oh, look at that.
Thank you very much. Kerber couldn't even react. Two points from it. I think they're feeling the tension in the Puerto Rican camp.
She has missed it. Championship point for Monica Puig. She just slipped as she was hitting that forehand, Puig.
Great work from Kerber, steadying, outmaneuvering Puig.
She gets out of it. Kerber saves the match point for 5-1. National serve for the title. Puig I still believe it would get interesting if she breaks here, Kerber. If she breaks here. Taking it so early, creating the angle, Kerber.
She's not done with. Obviously going to make Puig work for this.
Carl Long, overruled by the chair. Love 30.
And they'll be hanging on every stroke in the hometown of San Juan in Puerto Rico. Great return. Kerber keeping her cool, stepping into that one.
Let's remember that in her career, Puig has only played in two finals. So not been in this position where she's trying to close out the finals. Won one title. Strasbourg 2014. Kerber had a real chance there.
Just couldn't come up with the pass. Allowed Puig to stay in the point. She kept her cool. Also the difficulty of closing out a title, not just any title, Olympic gold.
For her, that's the biggest thing out there. Mixed success with that shot this evening, Puig, but that one was spot on.
Unbelievable miss from Kerber. It just shows what the pressure of the situation can do.
Just an understated shake of the head there from Kerber. Still stewing over that miss, Kerber. But she's a deuce.
Stewing also over the people calling out as she was about to make that smash. That didn't miss by much.
Didn't miss by much, but she hasn't played that shot before. Slice forehand. She had the chance to drive through the forehand. Fourth break point.
No nerves that time. Accelerating nicely through the forehand. You can understand a few butterflies in the stomach of Monica Puig, though. Huge moment in her career.
Through the first forehand on the inside end, then down the middle to bring up a second championship point.
Advantage, Puig.
She strode up casually to the net there. Kerber eventually wins the point.
Yes. Kerber hanging in this match by a thread.
That's the way to put it. She was almost out of it again.
Took her time and lined that one up. Another solid point from Puig.
And another championship point, number three. The net cord winner.
Have to feel for Puig on that. Nothing she could do.
She has been the beneficiary on those net cords more often than not in this one. Forehand into the bottom of the net.
Advantage, Kevin.
Kerber does that. She cannot take advantage of the good fortune with the net court earlier.
Yes.
Kerber looking very unhappy with the environment here in the stadium. And see her reacting like that.
She went big on the second serve. It didn't work out for her. Sixth break point.
Thank you.
Magnificent. Getting Kerber on the run, hitting powerfully, and finishing off with finesse.
Yes, it's inside the line. They've been erupting out of their chairs in this game quite a bit. They would like Monica Puig to get past the finish line. Fourth gold medal point. It's wide. Monica Puig has become the first gold medalist from Puerto Rico in Olympic history. The racket went flat. What a performance, Karen, from Monica Puig on this huge stage. She played lights out.
She most certainly did. She deserves this. What a beautiful moment. Not only for this young woman, but for her country as well. Congratulations. It was the manner she did it in. Played such wonderful tennis, believed in herself, and the dream has come true.
She set out in the semifinals. She didn't want to be woken up from this dream. She will not want to be woken up for a long time.
And ladies and gentlemen, the nice hand for Angelique Kerber.
An attacking brand of tennis throughout the week. She was on fire the first four matches, barely put a foot wrong. She's going to get the chair and climb up. Be careful.
She's not going to make it.
Achievement by just getting to this stage, to this match. She had become Puerto Rico's first female medalist at an Olympics, and now Puerto Rico's first gold medalist in Olympic history.
Ladies and gentlemen, stand by for the women's singles victory ceremony. Bronze medalist representing Czech Republic.
Medalha de bronze representando a República Checa. Petra Kvitová.
Petra Kvitová with the bronze medal after beating Madison Keys in the bronze medal match. She was on the receiving end of Puig's brilliance in the semifinals. she probably saw some of that final that we just played and would be impressed.
Silver medalist representing Germany.
Medalha de prata representando a Alemanha, Angelique Kerber.
And Angelique Kerber, the Australian Open champion, Wimbledon finals now, silver medalist at the Olympics.
A great achievement in anyone's language. Of course, she was hoping to emulate her countrywoman, Steffi Graf, just falling short.
Sure, we'll hear from her in the future about this match and how she can reflect on this match as it sad she didn't get the gold or the silver.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion representing Puerto Rico.
Medalha de ouro e campeão olímpica representando Puerto Rico, Mônica Puig.
On the top step of the podium, Mônica Puig from Puerto Rico. Must be setting some attendance figures back home in Puerto Rico in terms of people watching what she just accomplished.
The most extraordinary performance to earn that gold medal.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de Puerto Rico.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Puerto Rico.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino de Porto Rico.
She's won the gold medal at the Olympics, and I guess the question inevitably is, what can she do from here? And how far can she go?
First up, she should go back home, take that medal there, and show them. Do a tour in Puerto Rico. I think she's going to make huge steps on the tour. Already seen her improve her ranking 60 spots this year, and the performance here has really shown that she's ready to step up in the big events, take on the best players in the world and beat them.